You and welcome to this final day of finals here at the ISSF World Cup Shotgun Almaty 2023. My name's Jamie, and in a moment, but we are getting prepared now for the Trap Men's event, which will start at around 4:30 p.m. local time here in beautiful Almaty, Kazakhstan. The Azanov Shooting Club plays host to this World Cup, and it's been a wonderful host, let me tell you. A beautiful city. About 1.7 million people call Almaty home. 19 million people live in the country overall, and it's the ninth biggest country in the world. I don't know if you knew that already, but it's pretty big. The biggest country in Central Asia. And it's been a lot of fun, very interesting getting to spend time here, and the people as well have been wonderful hosts. But we're not done yet. We do have one more final to come. And after 69 athletes battled it out yesterday, this morning, into the afternoon today, we are down to our final six athletes ready to go into battle once again now in the final for the Trap Men's event. So we've got Italy represented twice in this final. We've also got Australia, we've got Kuwait, we've got India, and we've got Spain. There you go. You can see our six individual athletes on your screen there. At the moment, it is Kazakhstan leading the medal table, but there's certainly a chance for Italy or Spain to overtake them. We'll see how things go after this final. James Willett of Australia did qualify in first place, so I mentioned 69 athletes went into qualifying. It was James Willett with 123 out of 125, taking that all-important top spot in terms of bib numbers. Then we had a lot of shoot-offs to decide everything else, let me tell you, as well as to decide who made it into the competition. There was Moro de Felipez and Tuzan of Turkey didn't quite make it in. It went down to the shoot-off. Alberto Fernandez sneaking in into sixth place. A lot of experience out there. We'll talk more about the athletes individually once they make their way back onto the range when they're presented to the audience here. But it's been a busy World Cup, and it does come down to this final now. A little earlier, in case you missed it, we did have the Trap Women's event. It was a great final. The bronze medal went to Catherine Skinner of Australia. And then there will be later, when we have our award ceremony, double podium finish for Spain. So Fatima Galvez took the silver, and it was the youngster, Mar Molne Magrina, 21 years of age, who took the gold medal. Just her second individual World Cup gold, both coming this year. So she's doing it already, but I think it's fair to say she's got a bright future in the sport as well. So, it's the turn of the men now, and we're going to have our athletes firing at up to 50 clays that will be thrown at them from five different positions or stations. We'll be using stations 1 to 5. The first elimination will take place after 25 targets, so the athlete with the lowest score will be eliminated at that point. And then after every 5 targets, the eliminations will continue until the bronze medal's been decided after 40. Then we have 10 more targets to decide for gold medal. Now, I mentioned the bib numbers in terms of qualifying positions. That's really important. I'm going to come back to that in a moment. But first, let's meet our athletes. Alberto Fernandez, 39 years of age. Legend. Simple as that, really. Two-time world champion, 17 World Cup medals. The last individual gold he picked up was in 2022 in Lima. That was his last individual medal, in fact. And this is his first final this season. So looking to add to that total of 17 World Cup medals.
Number five, representing India, is Mendiratta Honi.
So Mendiratta of India secured the country's first quota place for the Paris Olympics, taking fourth place at the World Championships in Croatia last year. Has trapped Team Silver from the World Cup in Changwon last year, and looking for his first individual medal because he's appearing in his first final at a World Cup. Best previous finish was 23. All right then, we are now with Giovanni Pelliello of Italy, one of two Italians competing in this final. Another man with a lot of experience, a four-time world champion, 20 World Cup medals, and his last individual medal came at the New Delhi World Cup, which was silver in 2017. First final this year at a World Cup. Once again, we're talking experience. We are talking experience. From Kuwait here, we do have Khaled Al-Muttaf, 44 years of age, world number 11. He's appeared in two Olympic finals, Sydney and Athens. World champion in 2002, four World Cup medals. The last was in 2009, the last individual bronze in Cairo. Does have mixed team bronze from Changwon 2018. And now it's our second Italian competing in this final. Also had two in the last final. It's Massimo Fabrizi, 45 years of age, London 2012 Olympic silver medalist. Nine World Cup medals, four of them are gold. Last medal at the World Cup was a team medal in 2022, the bronze. Did take gold, individual gold in Acapulco 2015. Qualifying, as I mentioned, in top spot with 123 out of 125. It's James Willis of Australia, 27 years of age, and has 11 World Cup medals across the trap disciplines. Individual gold from Acapulco 2019, and this is his first final appearance at a World Cup this year. So we're now going to meet the officials in charge for this final. Worked very hard throughout the week, or a little over a week now. It comes down, as I said, to this final. We'll see how far it goes. Could there be a shoot-off? We'll find out. So we've met our jury member in charge. We're now meeting our referee in charge. Now, I mentioned the qualification numbers, the bib numbers. They're really important because when our elimination starts, so the first one being after 25 targets, if there is a tie-break situation for more than one athlete to be eliminated, then we're going to look at the bib numbers. So James Willett has the best bib number, qualifying in first place. So you'll see a number one next to his name there, but also on his back as well. He's safe. However, Fernandez has the weakest bib number. So if he was in that tiebreak situation with James Willett, say both on, let's say, 22 hits, then it would be Fernandez leaving the competition based on that bib number. And that will continue, including to decide the bronze. However, when it comes to the gold medal, it will come down to a good old-fashioned shoot-off, which for us, I think, as spectators, it's where the fun begins. But I think for the coaches there, Richard Salmon of Australia, and I think for the athletes, it's fair to say it's not fun. That's when the sport really gets to its most tense. Not looking too tense at the moment, Marco Conti. Busy day for Italy. Looking quite relaxed at the moment, but we're not quite underway yet. Just in a test fire phase of preparations. Khaled Al-Muttaf of Kuwait. Very experienced shooter, making his preparations. And that's Senti Mirko, who is coaching Al-Muttaf of Kuwait. And there we have another experienced individual there, Giovanni Pelliello. And this young man, Vanish Mentirata of Italy, as I mentioned, secured the country's first quota place for the Paris Olympics. Russell Marquez, coach, will be leaving the Indian coaching team after this World Cup, it's been announced. So he'll be looking to sign out in style with one of his team, picking up a medal here. And we are off. James Willett getting off the mark there. And the same for Fabrizi. Russell Mark was telling me that the weather conditions this morning for qualification were pretty much as good as it gets for the shooters. Beautiful clear skies, sunny day, very little breeze. Things changed, clouded over a bit, but it could have been a lot worse. There was talk of rain this afternoon, but no sign of that at the moment. We do have a fair bit of cloud cover, but the breeze isn't too heavy. It's a nice breeze out there. And no sign of any rain clouds as far as I can see. The sun is in and out as well. Back with James Willett now for his second target, which he does not take. He'll remain on one hit for now. And meanwhile, Fabrizi will move on to a two hits. Second hit for our athlete from Kuwait. And we're back with Perello. And he did not struggle there like I struggled with pronouncing his name. Two hits. Oh, I think that was a... Just waiting for the scoreboard confirmation, but it looked like a miss for the young Indian shooter. Was it a no target? No, he's going against a no target. No problem there. So it's two hits now for Mendirata of India. We're with Alberto Fernandez. Boom. He takes that. He's off the mark. One hit. Two out of three for James Willett, qualifying in at top spot, coming into the competition in fine form. And that's a miss there for Fabrizi, who is also now on two, staying on two. The same number as Almutaf, who has a chance to move to three, which he takes. And a nice hit for Bellelio there of Italy. You can see the graphic on your screen showing you the different numbers. 25 is where the first elimination takes place. And we really speed up then as athletes leave and the eliminations come thick and fast after every five targets until the bronze medal's been decided. So there was a miss for India there. We're with Alberto Fernandez now, his third target of this final. And he takes it, two out of three. Oh, it's a second miss for Willett. So he'll stay on two. The same number as Fabrizi currently. And not anymore. Fabrizi moves on to three hits. Nice one there from Almutaf. Yet to miss in this final. Same can be said for Pelayolo as well. Can't say that name. I'm working on pronouncing that name correctly, by the way. It will get better, I'm sure. And a nice bounce back there for Mendirata of India, who moves on to three, as does Alberto Fernandez of Spain. James Willett joins them also on three, but he is a target ahead. He's now had five and hitting three out of them. Good stuff there from Fabrizi, who is on four. So it's four out of five, his first five targets. And five out of five for Al-Mutaf of Kuwait. And the same total for Pelliello of Italy, also on five out of five. And a great shot there from Mendaretta of India, who moves up onto four. So Alberto Fernandez, no problem there. He's also on two of four. Five targets now for all of our athletes have been had. Two of them on five out of five, and they are the leaders. James Willett moves on to four after target six. Still no miss for the man from Kuwait there. He's on to six. Campelliello, join him. Yep, he can. So also on six, yet to miss. A great hit there from Mendaretta, who's on to five. Just one miss so far. And Alberto Fernandez is also on to five as well. So it's tight. It's tight out there. James Willett, one behind. He's currently trailing, but looking good there to move his total to five. Same as Fabrizi, but Fabrizi does have target seven still to come. And he takes it. So he'll move on to a six. We're still with Al-Mutaf of Kuwait. Oh, that's his first miss of this final, so he'll stay on six hits. Pelliello, the only one left now with a perfect record. And I did not curse him because he keeps that record intact. Seven hits now for the Italian. Six for our young man from India, Mendaretta. And we're with Fernandez, his seventh target and his sixth hit. So just one miss for the Spaniards so far. Great day for Spain in terms of the women's event, taking two medals, silver and gold. James Willett, meanwhile, has moved on to six hits. So after a bit of a wobbly start for Willett, who qualified first, he's settled down now, finding some nice rhythm and consistency. And Al-Mutaf, after that, what is, as things stand, a rare miss. He bounces back, he's on to seven. Nice stuff from Pelliello. Eight out of eight. Seven out of eight for Mendaretta of India. And we're back with Mr. Alberto Fernandez of Spain. Looked like a miss to me, it was a miss. So Fernandez will stay on at six. We're on to target nine now, back with James Willett. That was a miss. So Willett will stay on at six, the same number as Fernandez, but Fernandez does have one more target to come still over Willett. And no problem for Fabrizi, who's only missed once so far. He's on to eight. The same number for Al-Mutaf of Kuwait. Currently the same number for this man. But not anymore, because it's nine out of nine for Pelliello of Italy. That was a miss. So Mendaretta of India will stay on seven hits. Chance for Fernandez to catch him, and he takes it. It is still Willett trailing in sixth place. No problem there, though, for the Australian. Another hit for Fabrizi, who's on to nine. Chance for Al-Mutaf now to also join him on that number. Oh, no, not yet. He'll have to wait. prepares himself again to go again. Not much between these athletes, but a lot of tension between them, that's for sure. And the tension continues, the wait continues for Al-Mutaf. No target. You just got to keep calm, keep concentration, and do your thing when the time comes. Hit that target. And that's a... It was a miss, but there is a bit of a protest here from Al-Mutaf. Not sure if it's been given. You get to go again. The debate continues between the athlete and the referee, who's inspecting matters. The scoreboard at the moment hasn't got a miss or a hit for our athlete from Kuwait. Looks like he's going to go again. Target. So the hold up continues, but of course everybody's being held up here. It's part and parcel of the sport. One of those uncontrollable events. You've just got to keep your composure. Here we go again. Maybe not. All right. Oh. Oh dear. No target again. As you probably saw there on your screen. But again, Al-Mutaf just has to keep calm, keep the composure. And like I said before as well, the other five athletes are also having their rhythm, their flow interrupted. It's just part of the game. And he takes it. Took a while to get there, but when the time came, Al-Mutaf took it. He's only missed once so far. He's on to nine. And this man here is on to a perfect 10. 10 out of 10 for Beliello of Italy. Menderata, meanwhile, moves on to 8. And the same number for Alberto Fernandez. Always looks so cool and calm and composed. There's the table, but we're off again. Beliello leading the way. I mean, he's not missed. He's got one hit more than Fabrizi and Al-Mutaf. This is target 11. Fabrizi just moved on to 10 hits. We're back with this man again, Al-Mutaf of Kuwait. Nice hit. So he also moves on to 10. Still only to miss once in this final. And he's just not missed yet in this final. Beliello of Italy. 53 years of age, four-time world champion. And that's 9 hits now for Menderata of India. Fernandez joining him as well, getting into some nice rhythm out there now. Another hit for Willett. He's on to 9, he's hit his last 4. Fabrizi, meanwhile, he missed his 3rd target and since then has not missed. 11 is his total. Also 11 for Al-Mutaf of Kuwait. He's still the man to catch. Beliello of Italy, Giovanni. He is now on to 12, a perfect 12 out of 12, and that is double figures now for our man from India. 10 hits. Over to Alberto Fernandez. No problem for the Spaniard. He's on 10 hits. We're back once again. Target 13 with James Willett. 10 hits for the Australian. He's one behind Fabrizi, who does have a target more to come. And here comes that target. And it's a hit. It's 12 for Fabrizi now. For Al Mutav also, which is currently the same number for Pelliello, but he's about to go. Chance to add to that now, and he takes it. 13 out of 13 for the Italian. Meanwhile, Baunish Mendirata, the 23-year-old, moves on to 11, and that's a hit there for Alberto Fernandez, who also keeps up on 11. It is James Willett currently trailing still, but very slim differences. He's on to 11. It's tight out there. This is the 14th target now for Fabrizi. And he moves on to 13, so just one miss for the Italian. One of two Italians in this final. Pelliello is leading the way as things stand, and that is another hit for our man from Kuwait. He's on to 13, same as Fabrizi, same as Pelliello. For now, not anymore. 14 hits now. He's still the man to catch in this trap men's final here at the ISSF World Cup Almaty 2023. And that was a nice hit there from Mendirata of India, who's going nicely at the moment. The same can be said for Alberto Fernandez, also on 12. Target 15 now, as James Willett moves on to 12. Not had a miss yet in this round of five. No target with Mr. Almutap again. This went on for a while last time. Hopefully won't be the same on this occasion. Yep, he takes it. 14 hits now. Oh, it's a first miss, not just in this round of five so far, but first miss for Pelliello of this final. Mendirata moves on to 13. He hit all five out of five there during that round. Same for Alberto Fernandez. So the one miss we had in that round came from probably the one person you thought it wouldn't come from, Pelliello, his first miss of the competition. And James Willett takes that one. Everyone is a crucial hit now, because we're, for James Willett, less than 10 away from the first elimination. Target 16 for Fabrizi. He takes that one, so he's on to 15. Trying to keep himself away from Willett, who is breathing down the other's necks. Currently level with Mendirata and Fernandez, but they've still got one more to come. So that could change. Remember, Willett does have the best qualifying position, the best bib number, which could come in handy for him. Oh, second miss there for Pelliello. So he'll stay on 14. He's no longer the leader in this final. Russell Mark about to watch Mendirata go again for his target 16. Currently on 13. The youngest competing in this final, 23. James Willett being the second youngest at 27. Oh, and it's a miss. It's a miss for Mendirata. He'll stay on 13. Can Alberto Fernandez move away from 13? He can. So he's on to 14. It hits. The same as Pelliello, who was leading the way. Could it be the same for Willett now on target 17? Yep, he takes it. 14. So Fabrizi and Almutav in a bit of a battle at the moment. Fabrizi misses there, so Almutav, who would have been behind on bib number when they were level, still is as things stand, can take this and move above to the top outright on a total of 16. Pelielo needs to get himself back on track. That'll do, that'll help. Moves on to 15. After such a perfect start and two misses back to back, really important for Pelielo to get that one. Mendirata also with another pick, so he's on to 14. Alberto Fernandez, meanwhile, moves on to 15. And we're back now with Mr. James Willett and target 18. So we are edging a little bit closer to that first elimination, which will take place after 25 targets. So sixth place will be decided there. And it looks like, sorry, Alberto Fernandez is he going again? Let's just see. Yes, he is. So apologies, that was not a hit for Fernandez. It will go again now. He goes again and he hits it. So Fernandez, no problem there. Cool as you like. He'll stay on 15. And now we are with James Willett, who moves on to 15. So Fabrizi. And it's a hit for him. So Fabrizi moves on to 16 to keep the pressure on Al Mutaf, the leader. He has a chance to remain the leader if he can take this. He can. So he keeps Fabrizi at bay, who does have a better bib number than the athlete from Kuwait. But that doesn't matter. Not at the moment, anyway. Nice stuff from Pelielo. He's back on track, I think it's fair to say. Mendirata now of India. Oh. That looked like a miss. Yeah, it's a miss for Mendirata of India, who is now behind James Willett. Fernandez also missing there. It's really tight out there. Fernandez and Willett both on the same total of 15. Willett's now moved on to 16, the same as Fabrizi, but here with target 19, has a chance to move up to 17. Can he take it? Yes, he can. So as things stand, before Al Mutaf shoots, it would be Fabrizi leading the way based on a bib number. But Al Mutaf takes that one, moves on to 18 outright. So that's the highest total we've had so far. 18 out of 19. Ooh, I think we'll be going again there. So another chance for Pelielo. Yep, he's got it. So it's 17 for the Italian. After that blip of two hits, after hitting his first 15, he does seem to be well and truly back on track, hitting now three in a row. His total is 17. Just being checked by the officials. Nope, he's going again, so I won't get ahead of myself just yet. Let's see what happens. All right, everything I said still stands then. Mendirata now of India. An important hit. I mean, every hit is important, of course, from the get-go, but particularly now as we get so close to that first elimination and Fernandez adds another hit to his total, which is now 16, same as Willett, who will stay on 16. Fabrizi, meanwhile, moves on to 18, so he is doing his bit, keeping that pressure on Al Mutaf. Who's also doing his bit. 5 out of 5 there. 19 is his total. And Pelielo, 4 out of his last 5. He's on to 18. So we had 2 misses in that round of 5 there for Mendirata, but he closes out with a nice hit and a total of 16. and Fernandez is on 17. So it's business time. Business time now. We are 5 targets away from our first elimination, and it is at the moment Mendaratta of India in that position based on bib number. Same total as Willett of 16 hits, but as we've mentioned, Willett does have the strongest bib number of 1, qualifying in top spot. Meanwhile, Willett and Fabrizi have hit their first ones of this round. Same can be said now for Al-Mutav of Kuwait. This is Giovanni Perliello. It was a miss for the Italian. Hit for Banij Mendaratta of India. He's on to 17. Fernandez, meanwhile, edges away from him onto 18. So it is really tight out there. Target 22 for James Willett coming up. He takes it, he hits it, he's on to 18. And that was a hit there for Fabrizi. So again, he does have a better bib number than Al-Mutav, but Al-Mutav with a target in hand takes it and therefore does move back in to top spot, which he would take even if he was level with Fabrizi based on the bib number. And that's a nice hit there for Perliello. Moves on to 20. So 19, keeping the pace up. Mendaratta of India. Steps up. And hits it. He's on to 18 now. The 23-year-old. No target there. So Fernandez will go again. He's on 18. Looking to edge away from Mendaratta and Willett, also on the same total. Can he make this target? Yes, he can. So the Spaniard moves on to 19, the same as Perliello. And we are now on to target 23. We're getting so close now. Remember, after target 25, the first elimination will take place. So Willett's on to 19. Al-Mutav keeps his lead. He's on a total of 22 now. After 23 targets. And Perliello, it's been a bit of a roller coaster ride for him after that fantastic start of hitting his first 15, but he's well in it still. Mendaratta as well, he's not done. He's hit his last 3 targets, moving on to 19. We're back with Alberto Fernandez. Has a chance again to pull himself away from Mendaratta and Willett if he can take this and move on to 20 hits. Oh, that's a miss. So it's very interesting now. 2 targets remaining. And look at this, Willett on 19, Mendaratta on 19, Fernandez on 19. Willett's now on 20, has got the best bib number, remember, qualified in first place. Alberto Fernandez does have the weakest, qualifying in 6th place. 22 for Fabrizi, 4 out of 5 in this round. Oh, Al-Mutav misses there, also on 22. Fabrizi does have a higher, better bib number, so he will now be the leader. And it's a miss for Perliello of Italy. Didn't see that from Mendaratta. Now, Mendaratta got that, so really important hit for the young Indian. And also a hit for Fernandez. Right. Willett's okay if he gets this. And he does. So he's on to 21. Fabrizi, who's definitely okay, the leader as things stand, moves on to 23. So we're looking at Mendaratta and Fernandez. Fernandez has the weakest bib number. Mendaratta, 5th place. Fernandez sixth in terms of qualifying. Oh, another miss for Almutaf. So it's also Beliello to look at as well. If he needs to hit this to be absolutely safe, and he does. So he's fine. He's fine. It is between these final two athletes now. If Mendoretta hits this, he'll stay in the competition. And he does. There's nothing really Alberto Fernandez can do here. He can hit it, but he will take sixth place based on that all-important bib number that we've talked about so much. Alberto Fernandez, he did all he could. 21 hits was his total, the same as Mendoretta, the same as Beliello, but that bib number was his undoing in the end. So this is how things look as things stand. As I mentioned, Fabrizi is the leader. 23 hits, one more than Almutaf, with two misses in that round there, who's got one more than Willett, Beliello and Mendoretta, all on 21. But bib numbers still really important. After every five targets, we will have another elimination. And a reminder that the bib numbers will only come into play, will only leave play, when we reach the gold medal. Then, after 50 targets, if we had a tiebreak situation, then, and only then, we would have a shoot-off. All right, we go again. Five away from the next elimination to decide who takes fifth place. We're back with James Willett of Australia, currently on 21 hits. Not anymore. He moves on to 22. He's a very calm man. Very calm man. On and off the range. And you can see that here on the footage. Same could be said for Fabrizi, moving on to 24 hits. Almutaf keeping up the pace, but it will still be Fabrizi leading this final. A hit there for Beliello. Every hit's important, like more important than ever. Because look at this, it's Beliello, Willett and Mendoretta still tied. Great hit there by Willett. It is Mendoretta who now has the weakest bib number. So he's going to need to better the score of someone out there. Nice stuff from Almutaf, who moves on to 24. He is doing what he can to keep that pressure on Fabrizi. Just one hit between them. 23 hits now for Beliello, which does put the pressure back over onto Mendoretta. I mean, the pressure's always there in a final at the World Cup, but the young Indian is not showing any signs of collapsing under the pressure. He moves on to 23 again. Level with Willett and Beliello. Willett temporarily at least ahead now. And the leader, Fabrizi, is up next. Takes another hit. He's on to 26, the Italian. London 2012 Olympic silver medalist. 9 World Cup medals in total to his name. Almutaf does move on to 25. There's still one hit between the two athletes there, Fabrizi and Almutaf. We're back with Beliello. Oh, he gets that one. And he's on to 24. So really important now that Mendoretta keeps up the pace with Willett and Beliello. Competing in his first final at a World Cup. Previous best finish was 23, which is his age. Young man. Achieved a quota place for his country for the Paris Olympics next year. Oh, could be a very costly miss there. We'll see. We're on target 28 now with James Willett, who takes that one. He's on 25, which is one less than Fabrizi, who still has another target to go over Willett. But can he take it? Can he make it count? Yes, he can. So he's on to 27, the leader. And a nice shot from Almutaf onto 26. So no change in terms of the top two in this final. Beliello just needs to keep hitting and he'll be fine. It's Mendoretta in the danger zone now. And that miss means the athlete from India remains on 23, so he will leave the competition next. A miss for Willett, who will be okay. Meanwhile, a man who's definitely okay, Fabrizi, moves on to a 28, the leader still in this final. We've had two Italians leading the way, Belliello, the first stage of the competition, and now Fabrizi. But it's a slim lead, just one hit over Almutav. He's hit 5 out of 5 there. And the same for Belliello. And a hit there for Brownish Menderata, who will lead the competition next in a fifth place. But he shot really well. He battled really well. 24 hits his total. And as I mentioned, youngest competing in this final. His first individual final at a World Cup. And yeah, his best finish, therefore. Big future for the young man. Already doing great things for his country, winning or securing that quota place last year in Croatia for the Olympic Games. And as I said, it is Fabrizi still the man to catch in this final. And the eliminations keep on coming. Ooh. That was a miss for Fabrizi. Haven't said that for a while. And a hit for Almutav. So that's interesting because it does mean we have same situation in terms of Fabrizi still leading the way based on his bib number, but they are level now, the two athletes, both on 28. And Belliello seems to be going nicely again on 27. Same number for Willett, who does have the best bib number. Remember, that could still be very important. Fabrizi on to 29. He has the second best qualifying number. Nice hit there for Almutav, who's also on 29, but again, with the third best bib number, he'll be behind Fabrizi in the table. Oh, now this is a real opportunity for James Willett, with Belliello missing there, to edge away from him. He does have the better bib number anyway, but a chance to have a lead by targets here rather than bib number, if he can take this. It's target 33 for James Willett. He's got it. He moves on to 28. And we're back with Massimo Fabrizi of Italy. No problem there for the Italian. No target. So we're with Almutav of Kuwait, looking to keep up with Fabrizi. He'll be behind even if he hits this based on bib number, but it's important to keep those totals increasing, because eventually, if you're still in the competition, those bib numbers will not matter anymore. But we're not there quite yet, and that was a miss there for Almutav, so he'll stay on 29. Really important moment now for Belliello. He's got that one, so it's 28. It's in Willett's hands. If Willett keeps on hitting, he'll stay in the competition. In fact, a hit there, which takes Willett up to 29. Does move him one step closer to remaining in the competition, but Belliello's not out of it yet. He has to hit his next shot, though. Fabrizi did hit his next shot, which is now his last shot. We're with Almutav. Oh, so Fabrizi is edging away even further in the lead. Now, this could be a very important shot. Belliello takes it. So Willett is okay. He's okay based on bib number. In fact, Belliello is out based on a bib number. And Fabrizi is definitely okay. He is the leader. I wouldn't say comfortably. You can never say that in this sport, but he's doing okay if he can keep on track. 32 hits now for the Italian. Almutaf on 29. A couple of misses, but he gets that one. He moves on to a 30. And as mentioned, it will be Belliello of Italy. There's nothing he can do here. Because of that pesky bib number, he moves on to 30. So the same total as Willett, as Almutaf, but again, because of the qualifying number, the bib number, it will be Giovanni Belliello to lead the competition next. Absolute legend, fought really well, got off to such an amazing start in his final as well, hitting his first 15 targets. But he will take fourth place in this final, the 53-year-old, four-time world champion, 20 World Cup medals to his name. Now, let's look at our final three athletes. It is Massimo Fabrizi of Italy leading the way. It's a two-hit lead over Willett and Almutaf, who are level. Still are level, in fact, after James Willett missed theirs. And that does mean Almutaf has a target in hand still to come. No problem for Fabrizi. He's on to 33. And Almutaf moves on to 31. So Willett is trailing. He does have the strongest bib number, remember, and that's still important for the bronze medal, but that's only if you're level. At the moment, he's one behind. So Fabrizi and Almutaf definitely have their fate in their own hands, for now at least. Wow, things have got very interesting again. Another miss for Almutaf. We're back with James Willett, target 38. 31 hits, same total as Almutaf. We've got a battle going on there between those two athletes. Willett takes it, so he's on to 32. Meanwhile, we're back with Massimo Fabrizi, the leader. Can he restore his three-hit lead over Willett? He does, moves on to 35. From Almutaf, puts him on to 32, keeps this battle going. This is target 39. James Willett up first. He's in control here if he can keep on hitting, because again, he does have bib number one. He got that, 33. Fabrizi now, another hit. So that three target lead over Willett remains. We're now with Almutaf, who will need to hit this. And he does. So if Willett hits this, he will remain in the competition to go head to head with Massimo Fabrizi, but he's got to hit it. He's got Almutaf breathing down his neck. He does hit it, so James Willett will remain in the competition. He'll now be looking to close the difference between himself and Fabrizi. But Fabrizi's not having any of that, keeping a free target or hit a difference between the two athletes. Almutaf with the weakest bib number. If he does hit this, he'll still take bronze. And he does hit it. He finishes on 34, and he will take the bronze medal. The athlete from Kuwait. Put on a great show, a great fight during this final. 44 years of age, world number 11. Five World Cup medals to his name now. Takes the bronze medal and an embrace from his coach. Right, we've still got 10 targets to come, at least. If a shoot-off's required, we'll go to a shoot-off. Forget about those bib numbers now. James Willett versus Massimo Fabrizi. hit for James Willett there. He's on to 36. He's just got to keep on going to keep that pressure on Massimo Fabrizi, who has another hit to his name. It's been a long time since Fabrizi missed. I would say he has hit his last 11 in fine form, the Italian. And that's another hit for Willett. So we're down to the two athletes who qualified in first and second place. There was just one hit between them in qualifying, in fact. Willett with 1-2-3. Fabrizi with 1-2-2. But all that matters now is what's happening out there. And it's Willett on 37, Fabrizi on 40. They're just not missing, these two, at the moment. Another hit for Willett. Again, doing all he can to keep that pressure on Fabrizi, to keep breathing down his neck. But the Italian is not buckling. He's not feeling, well, I'm sure he is feeling the pressure. I can't speak for him, but he's showing no signs of it anyway. He's on to 41. Oh, a miss for James Willett. Which could be a game changer. If Fabrizi takes this, it'll be a four-hit difference. And he does. So if my math is correct, the best James Willett could do now is force a shoot-off. With four targets remaining, four the difference. He's just got to keep on hitting and hope that Massimo Fabrizi keeps on missing. He does his job, but Fabrizi can hit this. And it'll be over. And he does. 43 hits, the coach knows it. It's been a valiant effort from James Willett. There was a few moments where it looked like he might be leaving the competition, but he fought back. And he'll take silver here in Almaty. Another hit, 40. And we're with Massimo Fabrizi. There's a miss, but it won't really matter. I'm sure it will still bug him though. Two targets left, three is the difference. Look at that. 44, Fabrizi moves on to. The coach loved that. And you can't blame him. Now for Massimo Fabrizi. James Willett's on 42. Can he sign out on 43 with his final target here? He is World Cup medal number 12 for the Australian. And he takes that, so he does move on to 43. And it comes down to this final shot now. just to sign out proceedings in style. Massimo Fabrizi, 46 hits out of 50 targets is enough to secure him the trap gold medal at this ISSF World Cup Almaty 2023. And he did it in style. He wasn't leading from the start. He had a few battles along the way to get there, including with the bronze medalist, Al Mutaf of Kuwait, but he did enough. And there's James Willett, takes the silver. So the bronze medal representing Kuwait, it's Khaled Al Mutaf. The silver representing Australia, James Willett, and the gold medal representing Italy. What a performance from Massimo Fabrizi. Wow. So that was our final of this final day of the ISSF World Cup Almaty, Kazakhstan. But we are not done yet. I'm going to get out of the commentary booth now, make my way onto the field of play, and see if I can talk to some of our medalists for you. So don't go anywhere. Hang around. I'll hopefully be back in a few moments with some interviews. Either way, we will have the award ceremonies for both the trap women's event and the trap men's event coming up very soon. I'm with our trap gold medalist from Italy, Massimo Fabrizi. Massimo, you now have 10 World Cup medals to your name across the different trap disciplines. How do you feel?
Adesso hai 10 medaglie d'oro in Coppa del Mondo, in tutti i posti del mondo. Come ti senti?
Meglio.
Better.
Better. Simple as that. Okay. And also, it's your first individual World Cup medal since Acapulco 2015. How excited are you to get back on that podium?
Dall'Acapulco che è individuale, no? Come ti senti a tornare su quel podio?
Ho lavorato duramente in questi anni che ne sono passati diversi e questo è lo sport. A volte si fa fatica, a volte le cose vengono più facilmente. Sono felice di essere in mezzo a tanti campioni e fa piacere continuare a starci.
He has been working hard in all these years, there have been a few years, and he's very happy. He has been, he's very happy to go back between all these very good shooters. And he said, this is the sport. Sometimes it goes well, sometimes it doesn't, but he's happy to be between all these very strong shooters.
Well, the hard work paid off. And finally, Massimo, tell us about the final from your perspective, because watching it, you had a bit of a battle with Almutaf going on for a time during that final, and then you seemed to pull away.
Dice, parlaci della finale, all'inizio avevi un po' una battaglia con Almutaf e poi dopo ti sei, diciamo...
Guarda, sinceramente la battaglia io sono stato concentrato sui miei piattelli, cercando, già era difficile cercare di non fare errori. Sentivo che gli altri avversari erano molto bravi e non facevano errori. Ho cercato di tenere tanta concentrazione per non sentire il campanello che suonava agli altri e che mi avrebbe distratto. Quindi sono andato avanti a cercare di rompere i miei.
He says honestly he has been focused on himself and the battle was with himself, and he heard a little bit that the other shooters were going really strong, so he just tried to blend out the gong and focus on his own targets, and
he won the battle with himself. Congratulations. Massimo, you've got World Cup medal number 10 to go and collect, so enjoy.
Sì, adesso vado, grazie.
Grazie, you are welcome. So that's our gold medalist for this trap men's event at the ISSF World Cup Almaty 2023. Don't go anywhere. We're hoping to bring you a few more interviews with our athletes from this final. And we still have the victory ceremonies, the award ceremonies for the trap women's and trap men's event to come. So don't go anywhere. Now with the silver medalist from Australia, it's James Willett. Hey James.
How's it going?
Well, I think it's going better for you than me, even though I'm having a good time. Congratulations, silver medal.
Yeah, thanks very much. Yeah, really pleased to come away with the silver medal after that final. Obviously started off a little bit scratchy, so really pleased I hung on there and managed to get through to the end and come away with the silver.
You mentioned it did start off a little bit wobbly for you, and you did qualify in first place. What do you put that temporary wobble down to? Because we spoke yesterday and you were really enjoying the conditions that we had yesterday, the bright blue skies, very little breeze, and that was the same this morning. But come the final, the clouds come over, the wind picks up. Do you think the conditions played a role in that wobble that you mentioned, the scratchy period?
Yeah, that's right. It was just a little bit of adjusting, I guess, to the start of the final. The weather's a little bit different than what we've had in qualifying. A little bit darker, a little bit windier, and just trying to get used to the final format again, I guess, and just try and find the rhythm. And once I found it, sort of managed to hang on. So I was pleased with the outcome.
Yeah, and the outcome means that you now have, according to the ISSF website, World Cup medal number 12. Are you running out of space at home to keep them in?
That's right. Actually, yeah, it's a surprise to me that it's number 12. So, really happy to come away with the medal and add to the tally and, yeah, keep moving forward now till we work towards the quotas. So, yeah, really looking forward to it.
And talking about looking forward, moving forward, what's next for you in terms of competitions?
Yeah, so home for me for a couple of weeks now. End of June, I head to the Green Cup in Italy, ahead of the Lenardo World Cup mid-July. So looking forward to that one, and then World Championships later on in the year.
Cool, James. Well, you've got a podium to get to. So congratulations again on taking silver medal, and thank you for talking to me.
Thanks, mate. No worries at all.
You're welcome. Thank you. So we've spoken to our gold medalist, our silver medalist. We will bring an interview our bronze medalist as well. So stay where you are. We'll be back in just a few moments with our bronze medalist. I'm with Khaled Almutaf, a world champion and a bronze medalist here at this World Cup in Almaty. Khaled, how are you feeling? You've took the bronze medal after a hard battle.
Yeah, it's a beautiful competition. I start to pressure everybody from the beginning of the competition, and a very big finals. Four world champions in the final, so it's a really tough competition and shows the performance for everybody. And beautiful, nice.
You're very experienced yourself, but as you mentioned, there were lots of experienced athletes in that final. Does that ever make it into your head, or do you just concentrate on your game?
It's not a battle between me and other shooters. It's a battle between me and myself. This is a clay target.
And you did enough to take that bronze. This is your fifth World Cup medal,
yes.
I believe.
Yes, it's my fifth World Cup. My last medal was in World Championship before COVID. So during COVID, you know, the situation is not that good then for traveling. And I start preparation for last year, from last year for this year, because it's very important here for the quarter place and big competitions. So slowly, slowly, step by step.
So you're building momentum.
Professional athletes, they know what they are doing. You know, they don't shoot randomly and they don't pick any competition randomly. So it's we are in good way. So we can say this thing.
You can. Well done, Khaled. Congratulations again on the bronze medal. Thank you for taking the time to talk to us. And hey, go and enjoy the podiums.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Right, we have met our three medalists for this trap men's event at the ISSF World Cup, Almaty, Kazakhstan 2023. On behalf of all of the team, thank you very much for joining us. This is the end of our finals coverage. However, we're not quite done yet. We do have two award ceremonies to bring you coming up very soon. The Trap Women's Award Ceremony, followed by the Trap Men's Ceremony. So again, thank you for joining us for our finals coverage, and we'll see you again soon. Thank you.